This meeting comes ahead of a Teresita Day celebration commemorated every 6th of February. On this day, the National Resistance Army raided Kabamba Military Barracks, which launched the five-year struggle that brought the NRM government into power 36 years ago.
I did not know that you actually buy the uniform.
While interacting with the young people, the newly appointed spokesperson of the UPDF, Brigadier General Felix Kulaije, explained that UPDF has for the last 36 years spent sleepless nights to ensure that Ugandans have peace.
The Myunga Fund is there, use it. The partial development model now has come in, use it. Now, those of you who are not in the villages, they are in there. There is arrangement for the urban areas, still on a partial model, which you are going to benefit from. And of course, Myunga is still in existence. And then lastly, love Uganda more than anything else.
The youth congratulated Kulaije on his new appointment and asked that the army takes over the new parish development model to ensure it benefits Ugandans.
Our elders live, we will be able to take on a more vibrant point. I think the point of now, how do we prepare to take on?
Tanga Odoi, the chairperson of the NRM Electoral Commission, hailed UPDF for keeping the peace.
No one who has lived in this country beyond 45 years or 40 years and above must know where the country was, how the country transited to where it is, the people relationship with the army, how it was then, how it is now, and you give a mark and credit to NRM. This is what I'm saying. As an historian, we cannot bury our heads in the sand. The Uganda was a failed state. The army had failed, the economy had sunk, the social relationship had deepened in a negative, NRM lifted it.
Richard Todwong, the NRM Secretary General, observed that the relationship between the NRM party, government and the army is a triangular one where each complements the other. He encouraged UPDF to continue strengthening the existing relationship with the public, saying collective responsibility transforms the country.
The military is thinking of building a strong economy. Now, if our brothers and sisters in the uniform are thinking of building a strong economy, how about we in the civilian leadership? What are we thinking about? To mess up the economy. That is what we are thinking about. You see, that is where the difference is. They are thinking of building, we are thinking of messing it up. We are evading taxes, we are under declaring goods, we are causing riots.
Story by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.